We've made it as far as Lake George. What's going to happen next on this crazy, misguided adventure? Find out right now. Okay, this area here isn't just tricky. You can run aground really easy. Might be dredging or punching. I think that's probably a pole machine. But I remember coming through here a couple years back with Tai Tai. That's all running around over there. You go over there and you get out and you get tangled in seaweed. Aquatic weeds out here. No wake, slow speed, minimum wake. Probably get a little bit fast. But I had to find those two guys right there. I would have run around for sure, those two Mertens. It's Lake George, one of the largest lakes in Florida. So running in this little boat, I've got this, this is a cutoff. It's an emergency, it's tied to my clothes. So if I fall out, it throws that switch and it cuts the engine. So when I'm running high speed, as soon as we get through this, these, you have to stay in between these barriers. There's no bridge, nothing here. It's just shallow on either side. If you go on either side of this, you have to be right in this marker or you run aground. See all this out here? That's why they built all this, because they dredged this out to make sure the traffic can get down the river, up and down the river. Right now we're headed down the river, which is north. It's a north flowing river. This is part of the St. John's River. And somebody's got a big cruiser parked out there. Not a lot of wind today, which is good. But the way we're going, I'm getting on the GPS unit, says the way we're going is off over there. So I'm guessing about where those trees are. Well, the trees everywhere. I saw a fish jumping over here somewhere. As you can see, not a lot of room between these two guys. I mean, a little bit too far left and right, and you'd be running aground. Now, I'm only about a foot and a half, 2 foot draft with this big motor on the back here. But that's enough to ruin my propeller. And although I'd like to have a stainless steel propeller, even with that, you can destroy the engine. This has an aluminum propeller on it, so if it runs into something, it'll tear the propeller up, but it'll save the engine. We're almost through this, and I'm going to look and see what these say. It might be still in a slow speed zone. What I'm looking at over here is those channel markers. But let's see what this says over here. Resume. Alright, so let's get back to normal speed. That's where I want to go. Looks like I want to go over that way. So, let's go that way. Alright. Thank you. Because I don't know how I would have found this. That's all that's there, this little slow speed sign. Without that, you have no clue there's anything. Look how shallow this water is. I don't know how far up this thing I can get with this motor, but it doesn't look like that. I'm going to have to do some dips with the... So I'll make sure I can get tight. Oh, Lordy, that's shallow. You can see the fish down in there. This is very, very shallow. Wow. I don't know if I can get her up inside here. This is about 6 feet, I guess. Okay, she looks kind of 5 feet here. This one real. So this is the seaweed on the bottom, which is going to get. I wish I had my mark finder. I'm just watching the bottom here. I'm not sure which way do you go around. There may be, I mean, if I get stuck, I can get out and pull her. But I'm not sure which way to go here. I thought it was to go around that side over there, but it almost looks too shallow. All the seaweed comes up just far enough to get clipped off by somebody's boat motor. So I'm getting blown here, but water should be pushing me out. So I'm gonna I'm gonna turn this off here. Alright, so it's only been like 5 minutes or less. But it's the scenery around here. I don't want to call it scenery because it sounds like it's decorated, but this is exactly like real life Florida. 50 years ago, all these waters were crystal clear because there wasn't so much nutrients in the water, so many nutrients in the water. Even here, up in this area of Florida, there's a lot of nutrient pollution in the water. And so all this water should be clear, but it's... I can see a stump over here, so I'm going to have to watch for that. I don't know what's sticking out of the water there, but plainly it's sticking out of the water, so you can see it, because if I want sticking out, that's a log. Man, that wasn't just a stump, that was a log. I'm not sure how far up I'm going to go. It's right here, slow speed all the way. I wonder if that means we can speed up. Nope, that's angled towards everyone. And no trespassing if somebody owns this property over here. A bit more over there. I don't think the spring comes that way. I think the main boil is over this way. I would think the further up the river we get, I'm pushing this in there and it's not reaching the bottom, so that's a good thing. Except running over there isn't a good thing. Because that's almost the bottom right there. I need to get out of this. like a pretty good run up this river. Sawgrass. I'm not seeking yet, so that's good. Saw palmetto. Everything here cuts you. Oh well. Alright, so I'm going to sail up the river here a little bit further and see how it goes. Might be able to see some.
Thanks for watching my program. If you like my videos, be sure and subscribe to my YouTube channel. And for an organized listing of my YouTube videos, go to my website, www.whereamiplacebos.com, and click on videos. Have a great day.